Hello, my dear students, myself Devi Prasad Sir welcomes to you all to this chemistry class. Today we'll study about the electrolysis of copper sulfate solution using the copper electrodes. Okay, now Hofmann's voltammeter is used as the electrolytic cell. The aqueous copper sulfate solution is made as the electrolyte. The cathode and anode both are made up of copper and both are active electrodes. Now, the ordinary temperature is maintained in order to carry out the electrolytic reaction. The electrolytic reaction is like this. The copper sulfate dissociates into copper ions and sulfate ions. And the water dissociates into hydrogen and hydroxyl ions. The reaction at the cathode is the copper ions migrate towards the cathode and each copper ions gains 2 electrons to form the copper metal. Therefore, the product at the cathode is copper metal. Reaction at the anode. Each copper loses 2 electrons and they form copper ions, that is Cu2 plus ions. The product at the anode is nil since copper ions are formed at the anode and copper is an active electrode. The process of oxidation takes place at the anode and hence it is called as an oxidizing electrode. The electrolyte aqueous copper sulfate may be acidified with the traces of dilute sulfuric acid. It enhances the conductivity of the electrolyte and may prevent hydrolysis of the electrolyte. The blue color of the copper sulfate solution remains unchanged during the electrolytic reaction of aqueous copper sulfate using the copper electrodes, but fades away when platinum electrodes are being used. If copper anode is used for the every copper ion discharged at the cathode as a neutral copper atom, a copper ion is added to the solution at the anode. Therefore, the blue color of the copper sulfate, which is due to the presence of copper ions, does not fade. As a result, in due course of time, the copper anode decreases in its mass. If platinum or carbon anode is used, the blue color of the copper sulfate solution fades, since the blue copper ions, which are discharged at the cathode, are not replaced at the anode. Therefore, the product at the anode will be oxygen gas. The electrolytic reaction using the inert electrodes. Copper sulfate gives rise to the copper and sulfate ions, whereas water dissociates into hydrogen and hydroxyl ions. At the cathode, copper ions gain 2 electrons to form the copper metal, and at the anode, OH loses 1 electron to form the OH. Then 4 such OH gives rise to 2 water plus oxygen. Therefore, the product of the anode is oxygen gas. My dear students, using the active electrodes at the cathode, the copper ions and the hydrogen ions migrate to the cathode, but the copper ions are discharged in preference to the hydrogen ions, since copper ions are lower in the electrochemical series. At the anode, the sulfate and hydroxyl ions migrate to the anode, but neither are discharged, since the copper anode loses electrons more easily than the sulfate and hydroxyl ions. Copper anode hence shows a loss in mass. And using the inert electrodes at the cathode, the copper ions and hydrogen ions migrate to the cathode. The copper ions are discharged in preference to the hydrogen ions, since copper ions is lower in the electrochemical series. At the anode, the sulfate and hydroxyl ions migrate to the anode, right? Then, but OH minus ions get discharged since they are lower in the electrochemical series, which I had explained you in my previous video. Oxidation of the OH minus ions gives unstable hydroxyl radical, which forms water, with the liberation of oxygen. my dear students, I hope that you understood from this part of the electrolysis chapter. The next part of this electrolysis chapter you will get in my next video. Thank you for watching and learning from this video. Now, my dear students, you can correlate all the electrolysis of fusel bromide, acidified water, and aqueous copper sulfate solution. Thank you all.